CVD accounts for 27% of all deaths in the UK. Every day you've got around 450 people dying of cardiovascular disease, which then costs the NHS £19 billion a year to the health budget. And the northeast and North Cumbria, because of its demographic, has one of the highest burdens in terms of cardiovascular disease. So we've got very high prevalence of coronary artery disease, lipid disorders, atrial fibrillation, heart failure. Secondary prevention of cardiovascular disease is hugely important. The patient's already got cardiovascular disease or had an event, such as a stroke or a heart attack. Even if they're on lipid-lowering therapy, they have a residual risk. And it's hugely important to try and reduce that risk by reducing cholesterol, and in particular, LDL cholesterol to target levels, because we know the lower the LDL, the less likely they are to have another cardiovascular event. In addition to the benefit to patients, there is a benefit to practices because patients then are less likely to need primary care support and care, which then allows us to give more time to other areas such as primary prevention of CVD. We're focusing on secondary prevention and lipid management in primary care now because we know there's a huge burden. And also, sadly, because we're not doing very well at it. The other reason for why we're focusing on this now is that we also now have a lot more novel therapies that can help us achieve those targets. I think it's important we take a population health approach by making every contact count when we're seeing patients. And that should start right from reception through to the GP. So we need to be educating receptionists, healthcare assistants, nurses, trainee nurse associates, GPs, nurse practitioners, clinical pharmacists, pharmacy technicians, all these groups to be able to identify and manage lipid disorders. The other thing that primary care can do is to roll out the NHS Health Checks program to identify patients earlier, to offer statins to patients with a cardiovascular risk of over 10%. We should be starting with high intensity statins, and where patients have been given low intensity statins historically, looking to switch those to allow us to achieve targets and lower LDL and non-HDL cholesterol. Younger patients should not be excluded from that, especially if they have a strong family history of cardiovascular disease, because the earlier we start management, and that may be lifestyle advice initially, then the less likely they are to go on and develop cardiovascular disease. Proactively looking for patients who are not at target for secondary prevention. And we have a lot of good tools to do that. We've got the CDRC tool in the northeast and North Cumbria, and there are other tools that could be used to search for these. What we've done in Darlington is that each of our practices has a CVD lead. We're starting to identify a blood pressure champion and a lipid champion in each of our 11 practices, and educating everyone from the receptionist about why CVD and lipid management in particular is important. GPs in the northeast and North Cumbria and other areas of the country, if they want to, can access tools on AHSN website. In the northeast, we have the Neely Lipid Guidelines, We have a standard operating procedure for lipid management, which gives a lot of good advice on how to identify, how to manage patients with simple flowcharts for primary care to access. So I'm delighted that COF has finally recognized the need for lipid management and secondary prevention. So primary care now has two new indicators. One, that we get patients with existing cardiovascular disease onto a statin, and that should ideally be a high intensity statin. We then need to get those patients to a target, and COF targets are either a non-HDL cholesterol of less than 2.5 or an LDL of less than 1.8. You can also use COF indicators themselves to produce lists of patients who don't achieve targets to proactively look for those patients. We need to educate primary care on novel therapies on top of existing therapies such as statins and ezetimibe to also be able to achieve those targets. But hopefully by doing this, we'll reduce the event rate in patients who've got cardiovascular disease by reducing their LDL cholesterol or their non-HDL cholesterol.